Hi guys, this is Vijay and I hope you're doing well. In this video lecture, I will prove that Px equal to Py equal to Pz for Pascal law. According to the statement of Pascal law, the pressure or intensity of pressure at a point in a static fluid is equal in all the directions. To prove Px equal to Py equal to Pz, here we are considering the fluid element is of very small dimension dx, dy and ds. Consider an arbitrary fluid element of wedge shape or triangular shape in a fluid mass at rest as shown in figure. Let the width of the element perpendicular to the plane of the paper is unity and Px, Py and Pz are the pressure or intensity of pressure acting on the face AB, AC and BC respectively, and here we are considering the angle of triangle ABC equal to theta. So then the forces are acting on the fluid element is the pressure forces normal to the surfaces, and the second force is the weight of element in the downward direction. We know that weight is always acting downward direction due to gravity. So the forces are acting on the faces are, we know that pressure equal to force upon area. So force equal to pressure into area. So the pressure force on face AB equal to area of face AB multiply by pressure, it will act on face AB. So we know that here we are considering the pressure force is Px in the direction of x, and here we are considering Py in the direction of y, and here we are considering Pz in the direction of z. So whenever we derive the equation of force for face AB, so here we are considering the pressure force in the direction of x is Px, and area of face AB equal to dy into 1, because we know that here we are considering the width of the fluid element is 1. The pressure force on face AB equal to Px multiplied by area is dy into 1. Similarly, for face AC, so here we are considering the pressure force, here we are considering the pressure, it will act or it will act perpendicular to the face AC is Py and the area is dx into 1. So the pressure force act on face AC equal to Py into dx into 1. Similarly, for face BC, the pressure force on face BC equal to Pz into ds into 1. So these are the different pressure forces are acting on different faces of the triangular or wedge shape of fluid element. Here we are also considering the weight of the element. It is always acting downward direction. We know that weight equal to mg. Weight of the element equal to mass of element multiply by gravitational acceleration due to gravity. But here the mass is not given, so it will be converted into volume and density term. So we know that density equal to mass upon volume. So mass equal to density into volume. So weight of the element equal to volume multiply by density multiply by gravitational acceleration due to gravity. We know that the area of the triangular shape is 1 by 2 base multiplied by height. So here for a triangular fluid element, is of the element is AC and the height of the element is AB. So the area of the element is 1 by 2 AB into AC, and we know that the width of the element is unity, so multiply by 1. So it is a volume of the element, and already rho and g term is there. So weight of the element equal to AB into AC into 1 by 2 rho into g. Now we resolve the component in the direction of x in the direction of y. So for equilibrium condition sigma horizontal equal to 0 and sigma vertical equal to 0, to prove Px equal to Py equal to Pz. So first of all, we resolve the component in the direction of x and in the direction of y. So here we are considering the angle is theta and the pressure PZ, it will act on face BC and it is always perpendicular. So the total angle is 90. So this angle is 90 minus theta. So now we resolve the component in the direction of X and direction of Y. So here we draw the horizontal line. So this is theta, this is 90 minus theta, so this is also theta because this is a 90 degree angle. So this angle is theta. Now we resolve the component PZ into DS into 1, the pressure force in the direction of Z, it will be resolved in the direction of Y and in the direction of X. So we know that which term of force component which makes an angle with the reference line, this term is called cos term and remaining term is called sin term. So the component of pressure force PZ into DS into 1 in the direction of X is PZ into DS into 1 into cos theta and remaining term is called sin term. So the component of pressure force PZ into DS into 1 in the direction of Y is PZ into DS into 1 sin theta. Here we are also using the trigonometry rules. The upward arrow is considered as a positive, downward arrow is considered as a negative, right hand side arrow is considered as a positive and left hand side arrow is considered as a negative to resolve the component for equilibrium condition. So for sigma horizontal or resolve the forces in the direction of X. So the first force in the direction of X is Px into dy into 1 and the direction is right hand side, so it is considered as a positive. And the component of pressure force on face BC in the direction of X is Pz into ds into 1 cos theta and the direction of this force is left hand side, so it is considered as a negative. So according to the trigonometry rules, we know that cos theta equal to dy by ds. So dy equal to ds into cos theta. So put the value of ds into cos theta equal to dy. So now we can prove that px into dy into 1 minus pz into dy into 1 equal to 0. So px equal to pz. So whenever we are considering the horizontal forces, so at that time we can prove that px equal to pz. Similarly, resolving the forces in the y direction, we get py into dx into 1 and it will act on upward side, so it is considered as a positive. And the component of the pressure force on face BC is Pz into ds into 1 sin theta and it will act in downward direction, so it is considered as a negative. And weight is always acting downward direction, so it is considered as a negative sign. And we already derived the equation of weight dx into dy by 2. We know that ab equal to dx and ac equal to dy. So we already proved that for weight of element equal to 1 by 2 ab into ac into 1 rho into g, but we know that ab equal to dx and ac equal to dy. So directly put the value weight equal to 1 by 2 dx into dy into rho into g equal to 0. But according to the trigonometry rule, we know that sin theta equal to in front side upon diagonal. So sin theta equal to dx by ds. So dx equal to ds into sin theta. So put the value ds into sin theta equal to dx. So further we simplified this equation. So put the value ds into sin theta equal to dx in this equation. So py into dx minus pz into dx equal to 0. So further we simplified equation. So py equal to pz. So here we can prove that if px equal to pz and py equal to pz, so px equal to py equal to pz for Pascal. The application of Pascal's law is in any hydraulic machine, like as a hydraulic lift, hydraulic brake, hydraulic lift, hydraulic jack. So in any hydraulic machine, it will work on Pascal law.